What's up? It's Oliver Flynn, and you are watching and listening to The Sauce with Kenzie Taylor, and there are new episodes every Tuesday. Enjoy.
You don't have to sit, like, straight up or anything. If you want to chill, you can, but just...
Make sure it's real nice and close.
Exactly. Just, like, at least, you know, hey.
Hello.
Check out my mic.
Oh, yeah. It's a good mic.
So big. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of The Sauce with Kenzie Taylor. Today, my guest is Oliver Flynn. Hi, Oliver.
Hello.
Thank you for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. You flew in this morning, right?
I did at 6 a.m.
Oh, crazy.
Took and a little nap in between.
You came like all the way here for me?
I did.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I feel special now.
You should.
So, I'm just going to go over your accolades really quick for everyone. So, Oliver is an adult film star. He is AVN Awards 2022, winner of the Best Three-Way Sex Scene, and winner of the Best Orgy Sex Scene. Mm-hmm. And you have 10-plus nominations as well for AVN and several other award shows, and that includes 2022 Male Performer of the Year, and Best Supporting Actor for Psychosexual, and 2021 XRCO Awards Male Performer of the Year. So it's pretty amazing.
It was a good year last year.
Yeah? You think this year is going to be even better?
I don't really know, to be honest.
Yeah, it's a mystery.
It is. It's always a mystery.
Yeah. Well, I'm putting it out there in the atmosphere. It's going to be good for you.
Yeah, I hope so.
For both of us.
Yeah, for both of us, yeah. We got this.
So that's pretty amazing, though. Male Performer of the Year. What was it like when you got nominated for that the very first time, as opposed to like the most recent time? Like, how was that? Was it the same like feeling each time?
So that was the first time I got nominated for that
ever. That's ever. Amazing.
Before that, I got nominated the first year I was in. I got nominated for Best Male Newcomer. Mm. I was in for like 6 months. And mm-hmm. that one was cool. And then I didn't get any the next year. I don't think I got any. But I was also not working as much.
Yeah. Is that when you were contracted?
It was mostly in Florida the second year I was in.
Okay.
So less nominations for Florida scenes.
Mm-hmm.
And then the last year was when I was contracted.
So okay.
Most of the scenes that those are nominated for were Vixen or Deeper or Tushy. Did nice. All those for...
Yeah, I did a little Tushy with you.
Yeah, we did. It was great.
Yeah.
It was a good one.
It was nice. You feel very nice in my
bed.
Thank you.
That's what a lot of people say. They say that normally the uncircumcised guys feel better, but
oh,
I don't know.
Everyone's different. I will say that. Every cock's different. Yeah. So, but anyway, enough about anal. So, Psychosexual, do you like acting?
Acting's my favorite part. Well, not... It's up there with the sex. The sex is great.
Of course, you know? Yeah.
But I do like the acting scenes. That's why I really liked being with Vixen for that year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Because the corny stuff's fun, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Corny. But I really like intense acting. So it's a goal of mine to go into mainstream.
That's amazing. Have you ever taken acting classes?
I have not.
No. Do you want to?
I do. I was told there's a couple good ones out here. It's just difficult since I live in Florida.
Yeah.
There's not like good ones out there.
Yeah. Really. Maybe you could just come stay here for like a couple of months. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because also there's those master classes because I've been looking into those and those are like virtual.
Oh, so. Really?
Mm-hmm. Mm. I feel like I'm whistling. Why is it so loud? I'm just whistling. Yeah. So, Oliver.
What's up?
What's your favorite color?
My favorite color is purple.
Purple?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cute. Mine's orange.
Orange. That's a nice one.
I don't know. It's been my favorite color since like third grade.
Yeah, same.
Purple's, weird fun fact.
Purple's always been my favorite color.
So you're a fellow Michigander.
I am.
Like myself.
Yes.
Where out in Michigan, do you say?
So grew up in Mount Clemens, closer to Detroit, and then mm-hmm. went to Macomb. And that's where I went to high school. And then I moved to Kalamazoo for college.
Oh, I party there a lot.
Oh, yeah.
They have awesome breweries, too.
They really do.
Can't drink them anymore, but fuck, they were good at the time.
That was real good. Yeah.
Do you miss living there at all?
I miss the summers, and I honestly miss snow, because Florida, I don't get any seasons. It's just hot and humid, which I love, because
mm-hmm.
of the beach, and just it's nice down there. But I do miss skiing a lot.
Yeah. not a skier. I've tried it one time and I was terrible, but then snowboarding, I was like, okay, yeah, I could do this.
Mine's the opposite. I've tried snowboarding. I'm just not. But yeah. I can like wakeboard and, you know, all that stuff. But
yeah.
I can't go on the snow. I just
interesting. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, it's definitely a challenge, especially I think the hardest part of snowboarding, I'm not sure what it is with skiing, but snowboarding, when you want to stop, you got to like slide it and go and like lean forward, but not too much or you'll eat shit, which I've done a million times, which is why I have a helmet now. But
yeah, that's my problem with snowboarding. It's stopping.
Yeah. Yeah.
I just started spinning because I would lean forward and then I would lean back and I spun at a group of people like learning how to snowboard. And
really?
Just plowed into them.
Honestly, if I can't do it, I just am like, whatever. And I'll just fall on my ass. Yeah. And I'm like, all right, I stopped.
It's a good way to stop.
So how long have you lived in Florida?
I have lived in Florida for 4.5 years now.
Nice. How is it?
It's nice.
The ladies are very hot there, I will say.
They are. They are.
Very hot.
But I'm only there for like a week a month, so
yeah,
it's kind of pointless.
Is it kind of frustrating to only be somewhere 1 week, but like you're paying rent there or not?
Yes.
Yeah. I feel that feeling sometimes.
But my roommate, we split the house and we rent it out for shoots and stuff. So it makes it less expensive, but it's still, Florida's really expensive right now.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's the most expensive place in the US now.
Are you serious? Mm-hmm. Wow. I thought like Santa Monica was, but okay.
No, it took over.
Is it Miami?
Miami. Well, I'm in a place called Plantation. It's like 40 minutes out of.
Mm-hmm. I know where that is. Yeah.
where the old RK house used to be.
Yeah. So Seth's from Fort Lauderdale.
Oh, really?
But yeah, his mom used to live in Plantation.
Oh, really?
So,
it's a good area.
It's very chill.
Yes.
There's like nothing.
There's
it's very chill. Yeah. It's nice, but it's chill. You're like, what am
I
doing
here?
And
hang out with my turtles.
I love turtles.
I have a whole pond full of them.
Really?
Yeah, like 50.
I know, it's a weird, hilarious, very short story. When I was little, I had a pet turtle. It was a painter turtle. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if you're familiar with like dirt bike racing, but I used to be obsessed with Jeremy McGrath. So I named my turtle Jeremy McGrath.
That's great.
And yeah, it's just like the irony because it's like turtle slow, dirt bikes fast. Yeah. I don't know. It was funny. I was a little kid. Yeah. But yeah, Jeremy lived for a long time, and then I set him free.
Nice.
Yeah.
You always have to with turtles. They get too big.
I know, right? Yeah. I actually know some people that have like the tortoises, and they're like.
Those are wild. They live for like hundreds of years.
I know. Like you die, and they're still like, hey, what's
like,
up?
Fuck.
Yeah.
Where's my lettuce?
They're like trying to break out of their cage, and they're just going to eat you. I don't know why that always freaks me out when I think of that. Like. Dying around, I know that's so weird, but dying around like pets.
Yeah, and then they eat you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because dogs mostly won't, but cats automatically.
Yeah,
eat.
I don't.
They're
have
like,
cats.
Oh, you're dead. I'm gonna eat you.
Yeah.
Like,
do you have a dog?
I have a dog and a cat.
Okay. If I remember correctly, you have like a really big dog, right?
A Belgian Malinois.
Okay.
Yeah. She's a handful, but I love her.
So you like to go camping?
Oh yeah.
Do you take her with you?
I do. She actually saved me from a bear attack last year.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, so I have this tent that goes up. It's like straps to three different trees.
Yeah.
And it's called the tent style. It's like way up there. But I had it at like 5 feet this time. It was northern Florida by these springs. And in the middle of the night, 2 o'clock in the morning, I just feel this thing on my hip kind of pushing on me and going.
Oh.
And just like pushing on my hip. And I'm like, fuck, it's a bear. My dog is screwed in with one of those posts down underneath me. And she's got her own tent because she's. Bougie.
Mm-hmm.
And
she
just ripped out, like just ripped out of her tent, and I just hear her go chase after it, and I just hear like big footsteps going by, and then her like.
Did you have to say her name, or she automatically heard the bear?
She just heard it,
wow.
And then she ran so fast the 30 meter wire that she was on, it like caught her at the end, you know, because she was still sprinting, and she was like, and then got pulled back. And in the morning, she did it 3 more times. I don't know what else came up to us that night, but I was like a. Pinata, like in the tree, like just ready to get eaten by this bear. And
bear food.
The whole pole that she was screwed in the ground, the steel pole, was bent like this. Like that's how fast she was going. She would.
Wow.
I don't know. You know, they're brutal dogs. They use them for war. And
I mean, that's amazing, though.
Yeah.
That's what when they say loyal companion.
Mm-hmm.
That's the prime example.
Yeah.
I have 2 French bulldogs, so they definitely. If a bear was, like, coming at me, I think they would just be like,
Oh, fuck.
All right. You're on your own. Deuces. Because they're so tiny. But right. Yeah, your dog's like, I will literally murder you.
Yeah.
That's amazing. How old?
She is 3-ish. July 31st, 2019.
Have you raised her since she was a puppy?
Yeah, I got her when she was like 3 or 2 months.
Oh, her, so cute.
Her owners died. The breeders died. He died.
Oh.
So they like dropped him off at a puppy mill, and then I got her for $600 for a rescue because they didn't know what they were.
Yeah.
I You're like, papers thanks. And everything. I was like, thank you. I was like, I'll spend the money I saved on training.
So you have your Daddy Nature shop.
Mm-hmm.
You designed the logo, yep. And you've stated previously that it's a way of life that you live by. What are you planning on doing in the future with your Daddy Nature shop and all of that?
So I have a new round of merch coming out, more camping stuff, not just like t-shirts and hats and stuff like that. Was like the first like just drop. And then I did film some stuff out in nature before I was with Vixen.
Mm-hmm.
When I was able, during my contract, it was like very exclusive.
Yeah.
Very.
Yeah.
So I have plans to shoot more outdoor stuff. I got the website and everything. I just want to have like a big catalog of scenes that are all outdoors, like mm-hmm. beaches, mountains, jungle, rainforest. I'm going to Costa Rica in February. I'll probably film there.
That's awesome.
And then once I have enough, make a whole website just all outdoors. You know?
So you want to have a bunch of different, basically adventurous porn
yes.
in the wilderness.
Yeah.
It's or fun. Tropical places. Yeah. That's pretty awesome. Have you discussed like with any female performers, like, hey, do you want to go on these trips with me? Or is it kind
Not
of just
yet.
Random?
Not yet.
Yeah.
But, I will be planning it. It'll probably be spring.
Yeah, yeah. That's awesome. So other than that, you said you're doing more merch and stuff. What are you doing?
Mm-hmm. We're going to have hammocks.
Oh, nice.
Those are going to be cool. It's going to have the logo like in the back. Like, you know, this like kind of Eno.
Yeah.
Those ones, so, like canvas ones. And I'm going to figure out like designs for each of those. And then... like hoodies and bags and like camping backpacks and stuff like that. More usable things.
Nice. You know? That's really cool.
Yeah.
It's something that you definitely are interested in, so you're therefore passionate about
yeah.
it. Mm-hmm. How often do you get to go camping?
I think the last time was a couple months ago, but sometimes I'll just go by myself.
Yeah.
You know, if there's no one around or able to go, I'll just be like, all right. I keep my truck. My truck always has like bins in the back of it,
mm-hmm.
like waterproof bins that have all the stuff I would need to just leave if I want, you know,
mm.
just end up in the woods and survive.
Peace out.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of truck do you have?
I have a 2000 Chevy Silverado.
Nice.
Yeah. I actually bought it to transport my ATV and my dirt bike, but then my other car got totaled. So
nice. Well, I don't know why it's such a Michigan thing, but Chevy trucks are like
oh, yeah.
everything. Mm-hmm. Like my entire family, it's all Chevy trucks. Yeah. No Fords. Okay.
I used to work for Ford.
Yeah. Yeah. It's funny.
I used to paint cars for them.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So you did that before the industry?
Yeah. Just for like a year and a half, I worked for them. I had to paint or I had to work for the factory for a little while to work for the union
because
mm. That's what I was going to do. So I had to paint cars for a while because it was the easiest job.
Yeah.
You know, it was still not easy. It was like 5 a.m. to 5 p. or 5 p.m. to 5 a.m.
Time consuming.
Yeah. Just like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you ever get high on the paint fumes?
No, they had like in the factory, it was like grates on the ground mm-hmm. with water underneath with these big suction things that would just suck all the fumes out. It's like 120 degrees and it was terrible.
My drug addict brain is like, I would have taken the mask off I was wearing and just be like. Ah, fucking ridiculous.
I would have painted terribly.
Yeah.
All the new cars
who knows?
Like shit.
Dude, you would have painted like fucking there's no tomorrow. They're like, what the fuck, dude? You've already painted like 50 cars today. The quota right. was 10.
True.
Calm down.
True. Could have been like that.
So what else did you do other than paint cars?
I started in kitchens when I was 13 at an Italian place. And I went to school for culinary arts. I was a chef for a long time.
Did you graduate?
I did not.
Okay.
But I have like a semester left.
Yeah.
I just never did it.
Yeah.
Because really it was kind of a waste of money because I have like 13 years of like head chef management, front of the house and back of the house.
Mm-hmm.
So like having the degree doesn't really change anything to get another
yeah.
job. I mean, now it would, like, if I wanted to go back, it would probably help, but.
Yeah. I feel like when it comes to trade stuff like that, I don't know, because I'm not a chef, but I feel like just having that on your resume is pretty much what it does. It's not like, it doesn't matter if you have the experience, but also too, things are rapidly changing all the time. Mm-hmm. You know, like, how old are you?
29.
Okay, so you're 29, I'm 32, so mm-hmm. we're around the same generation of, like, we used to be able to just get jobs, like, by someone, like, hey, this person referred me, all right, mm-hmm. come on in. Like, now it's, like, crazy, or you can work from home, yep. or Zoom, and yeah. stuff like that, so technology.
It's, yeah, that really changed, COVID really changed everything.
It really did, honestly. I feel like, especially in our industry, it changed a lot with, yeah. like, the consent stuff and the paperwork we have to fill out and all of that stuff. What do you think about that?
I think it's better. Definitely with, like, all the boundary checklists and everything mm-hmm. and, like, just making sure everyone's good.
Yeah, you know? Yeah.
It's needed because, I mean, when I first started, it seemed like there was a lot of shadiness.
Yeah.
But they also weeded out a lot of people during the past, like, 4 years.
Yeah, cancel culture.
Yeah.
Got them. The only thing I will say that's definitely different from when I started. How many years have you been in?
4.5.
Okay. So I've been in 7.5. When mm-hmm. I started, we could be on set and, like, say you and I are about to work together and we're, like, touching on each other yeah. and stuff, and that's cool. Then we do our scene, whatever. Now it's like, I don't know. Like, I just feel like I can't be pervy in a way, but it's like, it's porn, so we're yeah. perverted, but, like,
sometimes.
So I have to ask, like, 50 times, like, can I please just rub your arm? Is yeah. that okay? can I rub your leg? Is that cool?
I haven't really noticed that much.
Yeah.
Because, I don't know, most of the time, I don't know, I just try to be the most respectful person on set.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. You really, I noticed, like, when I worked with you, you really stayed to yourself. You were like, all right, let me know when you guys need me. Yeah. You're just kind of, like, off and about.
Yeah.
And some male performers, they're, like, hawking you down, like, ah.
It depends on, like, if, like, I've worked with someone multiple times and yeah. we have, like, a repertoire going on and, you know, then it's different, you know?
Yeah.
Like, we'll just basically, if the cameras aren't rolling, we're still fucking, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Rough life.
They're like, can you save it for the camera? I'm like, I have more.
You're like, dude, I've got, like, 3 loads.
Yeah, that'd be
fine. Bear with me. Give me 5 more minutes and then we can roll.
Yeah.
So do you miss being under contract at all with Vixen?
I do. The only reason I didn't stay with them is because I didn't have enough time in Florida.
Mm.
Well, I was dating someone in Florida at the time. And, like, my house is there, my dog was there, my ex was there.
Was that the girl that you would never show her face?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So, I just wanted half and half Florida, LA. And I was
yeah.
here, I was just in LA for 3 weeks every month.
Yeah. But do you hate LA?
I don't hate it. It's just, it's not my style.
What do you talk about it? You're like, I don't hate it.
I don't hate it.
But, like.
But I hate it.
I hate it.
I like, I don't know. I don't like the city.
Yeah. Yeah. There are good parts of California, but I would say they're outside of LA.
Yeah. Yeah,
like, I definitely. Love San Diego. It's
yeah.
my favorite.
I just went to San Diego last week.
It's awesome.
It was beautiful.
We yeah.
were only there for, like, 2 days, but it was a great time.
It's a lot cleaner than LA.
Yeah. Yeah. I like the outskirts of LA.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Like the sketchy areas?
Like just like...
Where people are like living on the overpass where you pull on?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Those oh, yeah. 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 There, I don't know. I'm always like, man, I don't know. If I were homeless, I feel like I'd want to live at the beach.
Yeah.
You know
You're
what I mean?
You're allowed to. You just have to move spots.
Yeah, exactly.
You're allowed to live on the beaches in LA as long as you want.
Yeah.
Forever.
I actually used to know a girl that was homeless, and she told me different stories about living on the beach because she had lived, like, all over, but... She said she lived on the beach in Venice for the longest time. Because of that, you're able to switch spots. Mm-hmm. They can use the bathrooms of the day. And I asked her, I'm like, because I'm weird. I'm like, at nighttime, like, if you have to go to the bathroom, like, you know, more than pee, like, what do you do?
Very insane.
That's what she said. She's like, you dig a hole in the sand, you go, and you literally bury it. And
yeah,
I'm like
a cat.
Yeah, I'm like, well, what happens if like a little kid's building a sandcastle and they're digging? She goes, well, we try to dig it deep, but like some people are too high that they just kind of just
shit right out.
Yeah, it's like kitty litter. Like, yeah.
But it's better like, than
interesting.
It's better than downtown LA. Like I would walk out Olive and Ninth, that corner. I would walk out to like get food from around the corner, and there would just be like a fucking homeless lady just shitting. Just right on the sidewalk.
Uh-huh.
Like not like,
that's how it is in Hollywood.
One time I saw someone shitting in like a cement planter, you know, like in front of a restaurant. Just
Can you imagine be like you're eating and you're like talking and you look out the window and like someone's shitting? I'd be like, I'm good.
Yeah.
I'm good. I'll take my food to go. Yeah. Thank you.
I'll not eat this.
So for traveling, are there places that you really want to go to that you haven't been to yet?
I haven't really traveled much. In the U.S., I have. Canada, a bunch, because Michigan. You know, you can just hop over the bridge. And I went to Mexico for my buddy's wedding.
I love Mexico.
July of last year. Cabo. It was nice. Very touristy.
Yeah.
But it was great. We were there for a week. It was awesome. And then Costa Rica coming up for this music festival called Envision with some friends.
What kind of music is it?
It's like hippie jam band during the day and then electronic at night.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so
hippie
like
jam band.
Yoga during the day and then like...
Gotcha. At night. So it's like chill, get fucked up during the day, and at nighttime it's on. Party, yeah. Okay.
And they also have like skydiving, scuba diving, cliff diving, all the stuff that
I love
like.
Skydiving.
Me too.
You like cliff diving?
Love it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to go. I've never went yet.
There's a couple good places in the UP of Michigan.
Really?
One called Dead River Falls, which is not an easy one.
Yeah, I want an easy one. I want like the baby of all baby cliff dives that's still beautiful.
The Monroe Quarry, south of Detroit. Mm-hmm. There's a quarry there that filled up with water. And it's like, there's ones that are like 10 feet to like 30 feet. And it's super nice, clear, 100 feet deep, you know, water.
Yeah.
It's great. It's a fun time.
I really love Torch Lake, though.
Torch Lake.
Since we're talking about Michigan waters. Oh, so beautiful.
I go up there any day.
Anyway. So, what goals do you have like further on in your career? Like, what are things that you really haven't done yet that you want to do? Since you're passionate about acting, I'm guessing you want to do more acting roles.
Yes, I want to do like big feature stuff. I went to Barcelona or Spain last month.
Oh, you went with Kenna, right?
Yeah,
just went there. Yeah, she said
it was a good time. We did like a 5-day like digital playground movie. It was it was amazing.
That's awesome.
And it was my first time over there.
Yeah,
like, anywhere in Europe, so it was amazing.
Crazy.
Topless beaches and
that's nothing there.
It was incredible.
Everybody's naked. You're like,
yeah,
I don't want to go home.
No,
can I have a visa to live here?
I honestly like was asking how much apartments were in the downtown Sitges.
Did they tell you?
Yeah, it was like $1,000 a month, like on the beach, like above like a restaurant. And like the restaurant was for sale. And I was like, oh my God, this is the dream.
Yeah.
Buy the restaurant, live above it.
And you can be a chef at the restaurant.
Exactly.
You should do it.
I miss cooking a lot.
Yeah.
I think about like getting a weekend chef job and then just doing porn on the weekdays.
Do you think that you'd be able to follow through with that, or do you think you'd get burnt out pretty quickly? Because aren't hours when you're a chef, aren't those pretty long hours?
Definitely really long, but I lived for that. Like,
yeah,
I have to be working.
Yeah,
that's why like I when I'm in Florida I don't really work.
Yeah,
well, just because they're cheaper down there.
Yeah,
scene wise.
Yeah.
And they'll use me for like specialty stuff down in Florida. But it's hard. Like I'll go back there for a week and I'll just like lay around and I'm like, back to work. And
then my mind goes insane if I'm not like busy.
Me too.
And I overthink. I'm like, oh my God, oh, no one likes me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not important. I'm never going anywhere in life. and then I work again and I'm like, okay, I'm fucking retarded. Like,
feel the same way.
It's like so dumb. My brain. It goes like a million miles a minute. Who are some influential people in your life that have kind of like impacted you, whether it be personal, professional, and you don't even have to know them? Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior?
I don't know, to be honest.
He died for you.
Yeah, he died for us to sin.
Sorry to the people that are religious that just are listening to this.
Yeah, sorry. apologize.
No, it's not your fault. It's mine. I make dark religious jokes.
Good.
So
I don't really.
All right. So what really Oliver meant to say for his answer is Kenzie Taylor really inspires me to just continue being awesome.
Yes. She is awesome and inspires me to be awesome every day.
Let's see. What do you think people misunderstand about you most?
I think what people misunderstand about me the most is that I'm just always like Oliver. Like,
yeah,
what I am on set. Like, when I'm at home, I'm either in the fucking woods or I'm in a cave in my room playing video games, eating Cheetos and fucking Mountain Dew. You know, like, just, it's either a nerd or in the woods.
That's yeah. Like, so before we started, he was telling me how he always has headphones on because of gaming. So he's like, this is nothing. Yeah. And wearing my
ears. My ears are used to it.
I'm used to sweaty hot ears.
Yep.
Well, that's pretty cool, I guess, that, you know, you recognize that people misunderstand that about you, but you don't want that to affect you.
Yeah.
No. You know, and I always try to bring that to light to people that do not work in entertainment. Like, we're actors. We're getting paid to, you know, act and do performances.
Yep.
But when we're not working, like, we're ourselves. Yep. We're not our characters.
Mm-hmm.
Not saying, like, you know, everything about Oliver or everything about Kenzie's like fake or whatever,
right.
But
yeah,
you know, a lot of it is performance.
Yep.
So it's like, hey, I don't fuck 24/7. That
yeah.
is,
yeah.
that's not me.
Yeah.
I live a life, people.
I have a life.
Yeah. You're like, my dick will get sore. Okay.
Yes, it does.
You're like, I gotta massage it with like coconut oil and give it a little
20 days in a row. And then I'm like,
oh my gosh,
let me go home. Just go home, and then someone's like, "Hey, do you want to work?" I'm like, "All right, semi trip a couple more."
Yeah, you're like, I guess my dick feels like sandpaper, but
yeah,
fuck it, let's just do it."
Yeah. It doesn't feel like sandpaper; it's fine.
You said you've been in the business for 4.5 years.
Yep, close to 5, I would imagine now.
You think time's flying by?
Time is flying by.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't believe it's literally almost September. It's crazy.
It's terrible.
I know.
But
I feel like ever since COVID, like, I'm blinking and it's like, oh, another six
yep.
months, another 6 months. I don't know.
It's exactly like that. But in Florida, it was a lot easier.
Yeah.
And we were open, you know.
I heard that. Is that how it was? Like, no one cared?
We were closed for, I think, 30 days.
Oh my gosh!
Like fully clothed, closed though.
Yeah.
Like there wasn't like you couldn't go to the grocery store.
I love how you said fully clothed.
Yeah.
I was fully clothed only 30 days.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then I was outside naked all day. But no, we went back open pretty quick. People still wore masks like into restaurants, and then you take them off when you go past the door.
Yeah, because
COVID stays outside.
Yeah, COVID stays outside. Also, too. If you wear it walking to the table and you take it off when you get to the table, like once you hit the table, it's COVID's not there.
There's a COVID barrier around each table.
Well, when you go to the bathroom, you don't need to wear your mask.
Oh, yeah, no.
Yeah, because COVID's already gone at that point.
Yeah, and then the best is when you walk out of the restaurant and then they put their mask on to get into their car.
Yeah.
I've seen that a lot.
I don't understand the people driving
by themselves with masks.
I seen a lady, and I'm not even joking, this was about 9 months ago. I seen a lady here in Beverly Hills driving, and she had goggles on, a mask on, and gloves on.
Yeah.
And she's like driving like
windows up.
Yeah, like it's nothing. And I'm like, what the fuck is happening?
Yeah. I don't know.
Like, it's the plague.
But it also, just the whole COVID situation made a lot of people lose their mind.
That's true.
Yeah.
Also, too, I feel like it made a lot of people more brave than they really were, especially the keyboard warriors. Yeah. It's like you get to someone's face. Hey, remember what you said online? Yeah. I did not say that.
Never said that.
Yeah. What?
I deleted it.
Yeah. What are you talking about? There's screenshots.
Yeah.
Let's see. If you could live anywhere in the world, where do you think you'd live?
I think it would be South America or some sort of jungle.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I would build, like, well, before porn, I was thinking about buying property in Costa Rica and starting, like, a resort.
Mm-hmm.
And it was very difficult to do that over, like, the phone. So I would have had to go there. It's a lot easier if you're there. You can just like buy stuff.
Yeah. I heard it's like, really affordable there.
It is. It's getting more expensive because it's like very up and coming. Plus they're like the only country that's like fully renewable resources. Like no gas cars and shit like that.
That's pretty amazing. Yeah. Probably smells so nice there.
Yeah, just fresh.
No pollution. Yeah. You're like, what is this? Kind of like, why can't I think? Mackinac Island.
Oh,
like so it's good. So, cause there's no car. Okay. For anyone that doesn't know, Mackinac Island is a place in Michigan and it's amazing. And there's no vehicles. Yeah, it's only horse and buggies and bicycles and probably those scooters now.
Best. Yeah. They probably have bird scooters.
Yeah. But sure. That's it. But yeah.
The fudge.
Oh my God. I make my parents send me the fudge and Kogel's Viennas.
Oh, and the Traverse City cherry coffee and all
Oh,
that.
God. Oh, God. I also am disgusting, and I like pickled bologna from there.
I don't like bologna. I don't like bologna and hot dogs, because bologna is just a giant hot dog cut into slices.
Pretty much.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah. It's the only type of thing that I like, though, is just those hot dogs and that bologna. But, yeah, I get it. But the fudge,
I just had mom sent me a big box for my birthday a couple months ago that had, like, all different Michigan shit in it. Like, tons of different stuff. And it had a big block of Mackinac fudge. And I had it on my dresser, and I went outside for like an hour, and I came back in, and the entire thing was eaten.
Did your dog eat it?
This whole thing of fudge. Like
oh,
thick.
My God.
Yeah, she ate the whole thing.
Oh, was she so sick?
No. Dogs have to eat a quarter of their weight in chocolate.
No, I know that, but I'm meaning like shitting her brains out sick.
No, she was fine. She loved it.
She's like, oh, whatever. It tastes good.
She loved it. There was fudge all over my bed. She took it out and ate it like a turd. It was terrible.
What color is she?
She's like fawn with like a black face and like black paws.
Oh, okay. So you couldn't see like the chocolate fudge on her face. That would have been hilarious if she looked like the Joker with the with the fudge.
See how I got these scars.
Why so serious?
Yeah, no, she loves to eat food. I try not to give her human food, but she loves to steal it off the counter.
I know. Oh my God, my dogs. They give me this face and they're like, I'm like, God damn it. Just take this piece of turkey and get out of here.
Try to give her help.
Don't look
food.
At me like that. Yeah. This is a good one. Ooh. If it existed, what would the title be of a book that was written about you? Insert Jeopardy music here.
Probably Free.
Free?
Free.
Why would that be your title? You just want to be free?
No, I just don't really like... I don't know. One, I don't like rules. And also, I just like to, like, just be able to be free. You know, like in the woods. Like, I've done a month by myself in the woods. Like, no phone, no nothing.
Yeah. Just, amazing.
It's kind of fucked up.
Yeah.
Halfway through, your mind kind of goes.
I feel like 14 days without the phone. But yeah, after 14 days, I'm like, I need to communicate with like someone.
I didn't see a single person. I was in the Upper Peninsula and I didn't see a single person.
Did you even have service on your phone?
I don't know. I didn't bring it.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, you didn't even bring it at all. Damn. So Free is the title.
Free.
Interesting. Free soul.
Yeah, I just want to do what I want whenever.
I like that. Do you have a problem with authority? I do.
And that was like my problem with working in different restaurants and like managing places is when I was in a place where I could do the boss's job better than they could.
Yeah.
And then I would never get the respect because I was like managing restaurants at like 21.
Yeah.
And like I would just, people would be like, fuck you. Like, you don't know what you're talking about. I'm like, listen, this restaurant can be way fucking better.
Yeah. But, and they're treating you like you're like a dumb kid.
Yeah.
Yeah. I totally get that. I have been in not a chef position, but when I used to work in healthcare, like there would be people that were above me and I'm like watching them do their job half-assed. And then you bring it to their attention like, what do you know? Yeah. You're still in school. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. I'll just let you fuck up all the time and then I'm not going to help you with it though.
Yeah. Also, I don't know why too. Well, I mean, I do know why. I used to get in trouble a lot when I was younger. So like I have an authority issue with like police officers. It's not that I hate police. Yeah. It's just a lot of the times they haven't been very nice to me, but it's because I was a bad kid.
Yeah.
but yeah.
It's all situational.
Yeah, exactly. It's always different.
Yeah.
Oh, so, Oliver, I want to thank you so much for coming today to my podcast.
Thanks for having me.
I really appreciate you so much, and I adore you, and you're very handsome.
Thank you. You're very beautiful.
Toot toot. I'm tooting his horn. Okay. If you could, look into that camera.
This one right here.
Yes, wave at everybody, and tell them anything you have coming up, your social medias, your OnlyFans, all that jazz.
All right. Well, I have my OnlyFans are largedong.com or theoliverflynn.com, whatever you're feeling fancy.
Largedong.com.
Okay. I bought that recently. It's
yeah, that is the best, dude. Okay, go on.
I just released a country music song July 4th called Look Out My, Your Boy's a Porn Star. It's on every app, streaming platform, everything. Decent. And then yeah, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at The Oliver Flynn.
What? I had no idea you were a singer. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, if I would have known that, I would have been like picking your brain. I don't like country music, but I would listen to that for you.
I like all music. I just, my voice is just country for some reason when I sing.
Yeah. Well, do people ever tell you you have an accent? I get that all the time.
All the time.
Yeah. And it's weird because I go back home, obviously to visit, but I go back there to work as well for feature dancing. I just went back to Lansing.
Nice.
And I could hear the way that they were talking there. And I'm like, I do hear like an accent. Mm-hmm. It's so strange.
Yeah, I can hear it now when I go back. Like I just was in northern Florida with a bunch of friends from Michigan.
Yeah.
And I could hear it.
Yeah.
It
like, it's almost like a little bit slower.
Yeah. Wisconsin.
Like, yeah. Minnesota. Like we talk slower and yeah, there's certain words
little,
where like.
A little Canada.
Like when I say hacky.
Yeah,
like,
hacky.
They're like, hacky? No, hacky. Leave me alone. Okay, so.
Pop? Do you say pop as well?
I got teased so bad when I moved here. I had to brainwash myself to say soda.
No, I say pop still. Fuck it. It's pop.
Yeah. I started saying soda because I kept getting teased and it was annoying. But now when I go home, I'll say soda and my mom's like, yeah, she'll take a pop. I'm like, that's Mom, it. Calm down.
That's funny.
Okay, so awesome. Not only are you an adult film star, you're now a fucking musician.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, everybody. I'm just mind blown over here. I didn't know this.
Yeah, I actually recorded it like years ago and finally got the rights to it from...
Can you play an instrument or you have someone
to
do
it for you? I can dabble on different instruments. Nothing like crazy. I can't like play a full song or anything. Just like fuck around.
So someone just did it for you or you created
it? Yeah, so like- actually it's all about me coming from Michigan and going to California to do porn and like my mom, like I'm telling, this is like how
what's
I
the name of it?
Mom.
Look Ma, Your Boy's a Porn Star?
Yeah, Look Out Ma, Your Boy's a Porn Star. Yeah, it was
written. The title says it all, ladies it and all. Gentlemen.
Yeah. It was written for me. Music was made for me, and I actually was paid to record it back when I first started, so my rate was like a little, you know, like low.
Yeah.
Well, 4.5 years ago, guys started. Low,
yeah, yeah.
Like, real low. And finally got the rights to it like probably 4 months ago because nice. They never used it. It was supposed to be on a big album thing. And
so are you thinking you want to pursue more of that?
I do.
Has anyone hit you up?
No, like, I kind of just, I didn't really promote the drop of it. I just was
you
like,
should. You should.
Yeah.
I didn't Everyone, go video. Listen to it right now.
Thank you.
Look, Ma, your boy's a porn star.
It's a good song.
Oliver Flynn. Yeah. Thank you again, Oliver.
Thanks
I appreciate you.
Me.
All right, everyone. See you next time.
Adios.
Bye.
'Hey guys, it's me, Kenzie Taylor. Thanks for watching the Sauce Podcast. If you enjoyed this episode, which I know you did, like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I actually want to see you guys go crazy in the comments below. I would love to hear your feedback and questions you have for me or my guests, who you want to see on here. Let's just have some fun with it and get saucy. New episodes every Tuesday, so I will see you next Tuesday.